Hi, this is Salamanta Faria, an accountant and instructor here in the US. In this short video, first you will learn how correct journal entries are created for purchases or acquisitions. And then, in the last couple of minutes, you will see the underlying accounting principles. Purchases are among the most common transactions. All companies purchase services and products all the time. Let's first see the types of purchases and then move to the journal entries. Because how the journal entries are made depends on the types of the items purchased. What is meant by types here? That means, is the item purchased just a service? For example, repair of a printer or consultancy services and so on. Or if the item purchased is a physical product, is it supplies? Supplies are small items consumed in daily operations and last for a short period of time, usually for less than a year. Examples of supplies include office supplies like pens, papers, or cleaning supplies like gloves, paper towels, and so on. The other type is purchase of fixed assets, like vehicles, furniture, and so on. The last type is purchase of inventory. Inventories are assets that are held by a company for sale to customers. Let's now see how journal entries are done for each of these types of purchases in the purchasing company's journal. And let's assume that the purchase price or cost is $6,000 in all examples. Now, here is a blank journal. The date is just the date of purchase, and the description is just whatever describes the purchase, like purchase of so-and-so items. But this area, account and debit and credit, is the main part of journal entries to be populated based on the nature of the transaction. Let's first see purchase of services, for example, repair of an equipment. The journal entry looks like this. Debit expense, which is repair expense, and credit cash, if it is a cash purchase, or credit accounts payable, if it is a credit purchase. Next, purchase of supplies. So the journal entry for purchase of supplies will be debit supplies expense and credit cash if purchased in cash, or credit accounts payable if purchased on credit. And now let's see fixed assets. Here, no expense is debited. Instead, we debit the asset account. For example, if the purchased item is vehicle, we debit vehicle, which is an asset account, and credit cash if it is a cash purchase, or credit accounts payable if it is a credit purchase. Moving to purchase of inventories. Here, we debit inventory and credit cash for a cash purchase, or credit accounts payable for a credit purchase. Now, you probably noticed the credit part is just always either cash or accounts payable, depending on how payment is made. But to identify the debit part of a purchase transaction, I put together this simple flow chart based on the matching and materiality principles of accounting. So just start by asking, is the purchased item inventory? If yes, inventory is debited. If no, ask the next question and continue like that. The last question is the cost of the item purchased less than a threshold amount? If yes, expense is debited. If no, the purchased item is debited as an asset, which is called capitalizing, as we saw in the fixed asset example. Threshold amounts are just reasonable dollar values designated by each company so that any cost less than the threshold must be debited as an expense. All right, that's it for now. Drop any question or comment you may have and get a quick answer. Great, until the next one, take care.